स्टूडेंट वेलकम टू एडी लैब टुडे वी विल सी द रियलाइजेशन ऑफ जेके मास्क स्लेव फिफ्थ लॉ यूजिंग नैंड गेट एंड वेरीफाइड ट्रुथ टेबल सो व्हाट आर द कंपोनेंट्स रिक्वायर्ड टू इंप्लीमेंट दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट द कंपोनेंट्स रिक्वायर्ड आर वन इज नॉट गेट आईसी 7404 थ्री इनपुट नैंड गेट 7410 टू इनपुट नैंड गेट 7400 डिजिटल ट्रेनर किट एंड पैच कॉर्ड सो फ्लिप फ्लॉप इज ए building blocks in memory design. It is basically used to store either one bit 1 or bit 0. So in flip-flop we have three types. One is called as RS, set reset, other one is JK, and other one is T, toggle, and the last one is data. So in JK master slave we have two JK flip-flops here. We are using two JK flip-flops because the problem here with this, when J is equal to 1 and K is 1 and clock is 1, the output of JK flip-flop changes continuously, that is output toggles, and it gives some difficult, it rises to some type of uncertainty in the output. This condition is called as race around condition. So in order to avoid the race around condition, we are using two flip-flops, that is one is called as a master, other one is called as a slave. So here you can see in the diagram, this is the master section and this is a slave section. During this is the clock. This clock goes to the master section and the same clock goes to the slave section during the negative cycle. You can see here the inverter is there. That means the clock is inverted and given to the slave section. That means the master section works during the positive cycle of the clock and the slave works during the negative cycle of the clock. So in this way, we can avoid race around condition in JK flip-flop. Student, this is the truth table for JK master slave. When J and K is 0, both are 0, the output follows the last state. Here you can see output is Q T plus 1. So when J is 0 and K is 0, output follows the last state Q T. When J is 0 and K is 1, output is called as reset or 0. When J is 1, K is 0, output is set, and when J is 1 and K is 1, output is toggle. So this is the truth table of a JK master slave. Now we'll see the implementation part. This is the truth table for JK flip-flop. When J and K is 0, output is last state. When J is 0, K is 1, output is reset. When J is 1, K is 0, output is set. When both are 1, output is a toggle. So this is the truth table of a JK master slave. Students, we will see the implementation of a JK master slave by using NAND gate. Here we are using total 5 ICs, and in that 2 IC is 7410, 3 input NAND gate. So this is 3 input NAND gate. This is also 3 input NAND gate, and this is 2 input NAND gate, and this is also 2 input NAND gate. I have connected 2 input NAND gate here, and this is NOT gate 7404. So now first we will connect VCC and ground. So we know since it is a 14 pin IC, this is VCC pin number. So let me repeat. Since it is a 14 pin IC, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, this is 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, this is 14, and that is connected to VCC. Now pin number 7 is connected to ground. Similarly, I will do the connection for other IC also, VCC and ground. So this IC, 2 input NAND gate, VCC and ground. Similarly for NOT gate, we have a NOT gate here,
So here I have connected this NOT gate, 7404 IC, 14-pin IC in 28-pin slot. So here pin number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 7 is ground. After that 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 14 is VCC. So let me connect this one to VCC. So student, now we'll connect the input J and K and one more input preset and clear. Let me repeat, preset is used to set this one input and clear is to set the input to 0. Preset is to set the input to 1. Clear is to set the input to 0. Now we'll connect input J and K. Other than that, we have input two more input, preset and clear. The purpose of the preset is to set the output state to 1, and the purpose of the clear is to set the output state to 0. Now we'll see how we can connect J, K, preset and clear. So here you can see J goes to the pin number 2 and K goes to the pin number 4. So let me take two input. One is J that goes to the pin number 2 of first IC. Pin number 2 of the first IC, this is J. After that I will connect K. I will take one more patch cord K, and K goes to pin number 4 of first IC. Pin number 4 of first IC. So pin number, this is the pin number 4 of first IC. Pin number 4 of first IC. Now we will connect a preset. So you can see here preset is connected to the pin number 1 of the second IC. Second IC in the sense like 7410. We are using 27410. These two gates are coming under one IC. These two gates are coming under one more IC. So now preset goes to the pin number 1 of second IC, that is 7410. So here you can see I will take one more signal. This is preset, and that goes to the pin number 1 of second IC. Pin number 1 of second IC. So now similarly we will connect clear to the pin number 5 of the second IC. So clear pin number 5 of the second IC, 7410. So now we have done the connection of J, K, preset and clear. J, K, preset and clear. So now we will see how we can connect clock to this circuit diagram. So as I said, this clock goes to master section of the circuit as well as slave. But slave section is triggered with negative clock. So master section is triggered with the positive clock. So in order to connect clock, you have to short first 13 and 3 of first IC. Let me take patch cord and connect 13. So pin number 13, so 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 13 and 3. So 13 and 3 I have connected. From here I will take one tapping. From here I will take one tapping, and that goes to clock signal 1 hertz. You can connect to auto clock or you can connect to monoclock. Here you can connect to monoclock also, monopulse also, or you can connect to auto clock also. Right now we have connected this to auto clock. So now from this clock, the signal goes to the first pin of an inverter. First pin of the inverter, that is first pin of 7404. The inverted clock, that is pin number 2, inverted clock goes to the inverted clock goes to you. Here you can see
The inverted clock goes to pin number 2 and 4 of 7400IC. So 7400IC is a 2 input NAND gate. Here you can see this is 7400IC, 2 input NAND gate 7400IC. So this inverted clock, goes to pin number 2 and from here pin number 4. So inverted clock goes to pin number 2 and from this same point it goes to pin number 4. So now you can see clock signal is given to master section. Similarly, the inverted clock, because one end of the clock signal goes to the inverter and output of the inverter is nothing but inverted clock goes to the slave section. That means master section works during the positive cycle, slave section works during the negative cycle. Now we will continue the other connection. One connection is feedback connection, you can see here pin number 12 of 4th IC, pin number 12 of 4th IC, that is 7400 goes to pin number 5 of 1st IC. So let me repeat, pin number 12 of 4th IC, so you can see here pin number 12 of 4th IC, this is pin number 12 of 4th IC goes to pin number 5 of 1st IC. This is the feedback connection, pin number 5 of the 1st IC. Similarly, you can see here pin number 10 of 4th IC goes to pin number 1 of the 1st IC. Pin number 10 of 4th IC, you can see here pin number 10, 7, 8, 9, 10 goes to pin number 1 of 1st IC. These are the feedback connections. So other than that, we will do this connection now. Pin number 12 of 1st IC goes to pin number 2 of 2nd IC. Pin number 12, so 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Pin number 12 goes to pin number 2 of 2nd IC. Pin number 2 of 2nd IC, this one. Pin number 2 of 2nd IC. Similarly, pin number 6 of 1st IC goes to pin number 4 of 2nd IC. 6 of 1st IC goes to pin number 4 of 2nd IC. Pin number 4 of 2nd IC. Now, here also you can see the feedback is there. So, pin number 12 of 2nd IC goes to pin number 3 of 2nd IC. 12 of 2nd IC goes to pin number 3 of 2nd IC. So, pin number 12 of 2nd IC goes to pin number 3 of 2nd IC. So, similarly, pin number 6 of 2nd IC goes to pin number 13. So, 6, this is 6, pin number 6 goes to pin number 13. So, last feedback is here, you can see, this is the last one. Here, pin number 8 of 4th IC goes to pin number 12 of 4th IC. So, pin number 8 of 4th IC, pin number 8 goes to pin number 12 of 12. So, this is pin number 12 of 4th IC. Similarly, you can see pin number 11 of 4th IC goes to pin number 10 of 4th IC. So, pin number 11, this goes to pin number 10 of 4th IC. Other than that, we have one more connection here. You can see pin number 3 and 9 you have to connect. Pin number 3 and 9 you have to connect. Pin number 6 and 13 you have to connect. Similarly, you have to do the connection for pin number 12 and 1.
and pin number 6 and 5. We'll proceed with that. So after this connection, you have to connect the output. Output is nothing but pin number 8 of 4th IC. So pin number 8 of 4th IC, here you can see pin number 8 of 4th IC. This is pin number 8 of 4th IC. I will connect to the output point. So pin number 8. This is the pin number 8 of 4th IC. I will connect it to output. So here we have one more output, that is a negated output. We have one more output, that is negated output. So that is not required to connect. We will see only one state. So this is not required. So like this, you can connect all the different connection of this JK master slave. Now we will see the output.